So the wife of the slain Super TV CEO, Mrs. Ataga, has sued Niger Loaded for defamation of character based on the report they published against her concerning the murder saga between her husband, late Michael Yusufa Ataga, and Chidimma, where they talked about her befriending Izu and used Izu through Chidimma to take out her husband, allegedly. Also, the lawyer that shared the news on a private television, ITV, at Benin, also tendered an apology to the family of late Yusufo and the wife. Hi guys, you're watching M Chiki Series. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for your support. I quite appreciate that. It's good to have you around again. And if you're new to this channel, thank you for clicking on this video. Make yourself comfortable as we get right into this video. Also, hit that red subscribe button and turn your notification bell on. That way you get our latest updates. So Brenda Ataga, the wife of the slain Super TV CEO, Mr. Yusufo Ataga, has asked the management of Niger Loaded blog for a sum of 1 billion naira as a compensation for the publication of a libelous report, according to her, that was defamation of character. If you can remember the news that went viral about her befriending Izu, allegedly, and Izu happened to be younger uncle to Chidimma, whom she denied ever being her uncle when she had an interview with NTM. How they colluded to take her husband to early grave because they were looking for evidence for them to get divorced and for Izu and Brenda to allegedly get married. So based on that, she has sued Niger Loaded blog. It was on that blog that it was first announced. The first place I saw it, they wrote anonymous. It wasn't Niger Loaded blog where I saw it, but they are saying that the news came from Niger Loaded blog, because most people keep saying that the report was written by an anonymous, that makes it to be fake and stuff like that. So the lady made it clear that she's not smiling, eh? So she said that the report published by the online media platform is malicious and mindless attack on her personality. So she's not laughing, she has taken it serious. She demanded that the story be immediately pulled down from the website of the Niger Loaded online, while calling for a complete retraction of the damaging story to be carried out first in online platform news blogs and other online news. Okay, so she's giving Niger Loaded 14 days from the date the lawyer sent the letter to them to remove all the news, all those news from their websites and also online. Otherwise, she'll be willing to face the full consequences. Time this video, I don't know if you guys saw this video. I actually saw it, but I didn't want to pay any attention to it. So moving on to this Oga that sees in the secret and in the dark, Oga has taken U-turn. This man, this lawyer, came to ITV news station at Benin to talk about this Izu and Brenda case. So when I saw it, the way he was narrating the story with all his effort, with all his might, the way he was talking, I thought he has evidence, because after a while he will say, I have the pictures here, I have the photos here. So the man that was interviewing him did not tell him to present the evidence, because I thought he would have asked him to present the evidence each time he says, I have the pictures here, I have the photos here. I never knew that he was talking about internet. And on the internet, they don't have any picture like Izu kissing Brenda. I've not seen any picture like that, or two of them holding each other. I've not seen. So I don't know where the man got his own pictures. When he was narrating the story, I thought, okay, he got some good evidence. It would be nice to ask him to show the evidence. But the man interviewing, he never showed any interest. They kept saying that, I saw the pictures, I saw the videos, they're everywhere. Really? And now he has turned 360 degrees. He has made a U-turn to apologize to Brenda Ataga, Ataga's family as a whole, saying that he was carried away by what he saw on social media. If you know that you saw it on social media, why were you putting a lot of energy in narrating the story, telling people what really transpired, as if you were there when the story was made? Now this one, then the talk, Oga, talk the one you know. Know be what you'd see on internet. And the man is a lawyer. That's the irony of the whole thing. I thought he was even sure of what he was saying, not knowing that it was only online. If you rely on what you see online, you run into problem. So at the end of the day, he wrote a letter that was published on Vanguard. He titled it Refutal of My Narration as it relates to Mrs. Brenda Ataga and Mr. Izu.
But the story is that the man and the wife, the man got information that the wife was involved in extramarital affairs in Abuja. That led to their separation, and the woman was no longer coming home from Abuja, but she was not divorced from the husband.
Okay.
She was not divorced. And Chidima had a man who was the younger brother of her father. Let me say uncle.
Okay.
Who put Chidima in the University of Lagos? Who was paying Chidima's school fees? And that is Mr. Ezu. Now, the allegation and the pictures I have here, I have all the pictures here.
Okay.
Of Mr. Ezu and Brenda kissing at different positions. I have all of them in my phone.
Yeah, is there in the social media space? Yeah, is there in the social
media? I have all of them here. Mm-hmm. So, Brenda was no longer hiding the fact that Ataga is my legal husband, but I'm no more interested in Ataga.
Yeah.
So she was free with Izu in Abuja. Now the point now came up early in December last year, when because of the love affair between Mr. Izu and Mrs. Brenda Ataga, they now got to the point of saying, let us get married. And Brenda said, but I am still legally married. What do we do? And Izu was alleged to have come up with the idea.
This lawyer is very funny. The confidence with which he's narrating this story, it's like he's the one that concocted the story, he's the one that made the story, he's the one that wrote it. He's trying to emphasize on any action taken. I don't know how he got this courage to do this. On a private television, I don't know, because he knows people will be watching this. I don't know how he got himself into this. But anyway, he eventually made a U-turn. He sent out a letter saying that he doesn't know Mrs. Brenda or anybody in Ataga's family. He made his analysis based on social media information. Really? Thomas withdrew his earlier remarks, saying he has discovered them to be untrue. The letter addressed to Mbaseki Martin Obono, TAP Legal Services, reads, I wish to refute as incorrect my comments on the unfortunate death of late Mr. Michael Yusuf Ataga as it relates to Mrs. Brenda Ataga and one Mr. Izu. Comments were made without malice, and from expert checks online, I have found that they are baseless and false. So why didn't you do your investigation before going on television to talk? Because when he was talking, I thought he knew what he was saying. I didn't know that it was only from the internet. I have never met Mrs. Ataga, and I've also found out that there is no Mr. Izu anywhere. These were stories I read online by myself. I'm therefore very apologetic to Mrs. Brenda Ataga and the entire Ataga family for any embarrassment, pains, or suffering my comments on ITV may have caused them. It is also very unfortunate that it is not the entire interview I granted that is now being circulated online, as my comments were made without malice on any of the persons mentioned, particularly Mrs. Brenda Ataga. I therefore withdraw these statements, which I have discovered to be untrue, as I relied on stories I read online in the course of public commentary, as this matter has caused me depression and great embarrassment. As a lawyer, you have to be embarrassed, because I expected that he would come up with concrete evidence. But when he was saying he had the pictures, I thought really that he had the real pictures. I never knew that he was talking based on what he saw online. Video went viral last week. A lot of people made video about it. You're just looking at the man. I was like, you have the video, but you don't want to show it. You have the video and the photo, you don't want to show it. There is something wrong with what you're saying here. This has caused me great embarrassment from families and family members. Saint Refuta will be on ITV Benin immediately, please. This man is just a clown. So let me know what you guys think about this. Mrs. Ataga demanding for $1 billion for defamation of character from Niger Loaded. It's quite unfortunate the video is scattered all over. And this lawyer, that he didn't do his assignment very well, decided to jump on a story he saw online, and at the same time telling people that he is sure of what he's saying by saying that he has some pictures and videos on his phone. So let me know what you think about this. I'm gonna sign off here. Stay healthy and safe. Remember to share this video with family and friends if you love it, and subscribe to the channel if you've not done already. And I'm gonna catch you guys in my next video. Bye, and remain blessed.